So, you know, there is a danger in keep going back too far into history, and whether you're saying that, you know, all this technology the world has, India had 1,000 years ago and so on. I think without looking at that, I mean, let's see what we can do going forward. So clearly, some of the issues that have been brought up, which are underlying the legislations, including localization, etc., are real. So, for example, lawful access to financial information is a real need. Okay, whether it's the IB or the RBI or so many people want to be able to do that. Keep in mind also, India is a very key part of the global ecosystem in terms of supplying services, about $130 billion worth of exports, largely to the United States and Europe, but also to some other countries. We depend on that free flow of data for that. So, for example, the financial information of most Americans is processed in India. Okay. Now, barriers that we raise are not necessarily one-way walls. Okay. The walls work both ways. Sooner or later, even if there is no retaliation, India is an inspiration to many countries. Many countries are looking at India, Indonesia, Vietnam are looking at India and saying, wow, data localization, great, let's do the same thing. Already Indian companies, startups, fintechs who are operating in those countries are beginning to feel the heat, because they suddenly have to find that they have to spend more on localization, on support. It's not just putting a server there, it's obviously a lot more. If you just jump forward to what's happening now, I don't know if you've seen the news, but Uttar Pradesh plans to be the first state to put its own state data center, and it wants to mandate WhatsApp, Facebook, and all of them.
We'll come to that actually, a little later.
Yeah.
So that's the second point.
So if we are going that far ahead, this hyper-localization, that's the point I'll leave you with of the internet. You know, based on whether you call it a bogey or whatever of colonialism, flies in the face of the global internet as we know it. Of course, everyone looks at China. And China, of course, has shown that you can do certain things with a dictatorship by suppressing people very effectively, raising a great firewall. Okay. China is not a great example for us to look at, because you have to then look at the totality of China. We look at GDPR, but very, very selectively. You have to really understand GDPR to see. So therefore, when you say these things, you've got to look at where the global internet and the global digital economy is. And India's very key role in that. And both the example that we are setting with these digital policies, as well as the problems that we will face if there is retaliation. That's just the point I'll leave you.